Did you partner with OpenAI because it was the best technology or because it was good marketing?
EinsteinGPT, we're really thrilled to announce today at the Salesforce Trailblazer DX event here in San Francisco. EinsteinGPT is the world's first AI, generative AI purpose-built for CRM, and we are taking an open ecosystem approach. OpenAI is our initial partner, but we'll be adding additional partners in the coming months.
How does this improve the offering to your CRM enterprise clients? What is it that they're getting out of this?
You know, EinsteinGPT is really about combining Salesforce's proprietary AI with an ecosystem of vetted generative AI partners to create personalized content for sellers, service agents, marketers, commerce managers, as well as IT developers. And it's for the employees, it's about making them more productive. And for customers, it's about delivering more tailored, relevant experiences.
Because I believe you already deliver, 200 billion AI-powered predictions per day anyway within Customer 360, Clara. So how does the large language model change things up if you're a user?
That's a great question. So we've been on this AI journey for over 7 years now. We introduced the world to Einstein in 2016, and there are over 215 billion predictions that Einstein gives out every day today across customer interactions. EinsteinGPT is the next generation of our Einstein AI, and it includes generative technology, which means that content gets created for sellers, for example, a draft email to a prospective customer. For service agents, a draft response to a customer service chat or email. For marketers, dynamically generating landing pages and email campaign content. The human stays in the loop. They get final say before they hit send.
And OpenAI say, look, it allows them to learn more about real world usage that's critical to responsible development. I'm interested in that responsible development element because it's interesting. Some key financial companies, for example, have been limiting their employees' use of ChatGPT, worried about their IP, basically. How are you going to ensure this is a safe space for all your customers to work in?
It's the difference between consumer and business applications. Thus far, a lot of what has been covered in the news about generative AI has been consumer applications that are open-ended and frankly have higher safety and accuracy concerns. In the business space, we can really focus the use case, the job to be done on specifically what does a salesperson need, specifically what does a service agent need to do his or her job.
Clara, the other big piece of news is Salesforce's venture arm launching a new $250 million fund specifically targeting startups in generative AI. You alluded to it earlier about future partnerships, but what are you looking for with that fund?
That's right. Our new generative AI startup fund from Salesforce Ventures is really focused on investing in and nurturing the next generation of AI startups. We believe it's very early days in generative AI, and you know, there's a lot that we don't know yet. And so being able to have an ecosystem play is very important, and also to give our customers choice.
Clara, Ed referenced it at the start. This sort of feels like a PR offensive around AI or a bit of a marketing ploy. But ultimately, you've been doing AI for years. Does it frustrate you that suddenly everyone's talking about ChatGPT, or was it needed, this sort of conversation?
I think it's great. It's created consumer excitement and demand. My 85-year-old neighbor even knows about ChatGPT. And ultimately, you know, businesses, they care about AI in the context of driving business results, especially in this macro environment. How do I close more sales? How do I respond to my customer support issues more quickly? And so that's our true north in developing these applications in an ethical and responsible way.